So, how is it going, guys and girls? Oakley here, and today I've got for you guys some Call of Duty Black Ops 2. This is going to be an amalgamation of clips from the new Uprising DLC, which was dropped today. So, for those of you guys who haven't bought it yet and may want to check out what some of the maps look like, here you go. And this one here that we're on right now is actually a remake of Firing Range from Black Ops 1. I'm sure you're all very familiar with it. As I think this is meant to be some sort of film set prop location. There's just loads of random stuff around this map. As you saw back there by the sea flag, there was some like prop from War of the Worlds, I think it was, and there's a dinosaur, obviously a medieval fort, there's a shark lying around. It's pretty mad, but they kept the essence of Firing Range, which is really nice. It's one of my favorite maps from Black Ops 1, and looks really good, and it feels like exactly the same sort of thing, so I think that's going to be one to look out for. Also, moving on here now to Magma, which is essentially, well, clues in the title, it's just like, basically the main aspect of it is this like inclusion of lava, which does injure you, by the way, if you run on it. It does like, doesn't injure you that bad, it's like one bullet kind of thing, but it's still enough to be quite annoying, and obviously if you go into a gunfight with a little bit of damage, then you're more than likely going to lose it. But the maps themselves look really, really nice, actually. It's, I'm quite impressed with it. I'm not really a fan of DLC maps normally. I normally buy it for the zombies aspect of things, which, by the way, if you'd like to see some zombies footage from me later and a couple of other YouTubers, then let me know in the comments down below. I'll try to get an episode out for you guys later on tonight. But as you can see here, I was just sniping, trying to pick up this sea flag, trying to defend it to my best of my abilities, but I'm not that much of a sniper, so I get taken out there. But here you're going to get a pretty nice shot of what the actual lava lake looks like. If you fall in there, you're dead, by the way, so don't fall in that. You will be absolutely screwed. I think this is set in like Tokyo or somewhere like that. And then we move on to this one here. This map here is called Encore, which is, this is quite a small map. It feels quite small, even though it's not that small. But this area here, this under tunnel area, is just constantly got so much traffic going through it, as there's a spawn on the other side, and obviously it's quite close to the B flag, so this is going to be an area to try to lock down and try to look out for. Be careful, it is two-story as well, so people can shoot you through the tarpaulin or whatever it is above you. That happened to me earlier when I was on a nice little streak, and it was really, really frustrating, so definitely watch out for that. But this is the spawn here now that I was telling you about. That's on the other side, or the entrance to that little tunnel area, if you like. And it kind of just all seems, I guess it's because the maps are new, but everything just seems to converge around the middle of the map, around the B flag. So just get your little head glitch spots out to the best of your ability. And right here, this is the final map. This is called Vertigo, which is a completely new map. It's like on a skyscraper or something, I guess. I think this is meant to be taken out from the actual multiplayer campaign. So right here, you're going to see me picking up the B flag like a boss. And the mistake that a lot of people make is running down straight where that chap there on the left of me just ran down on the beginning of the map. And basically the two rooms just look directly at each other. So it's going to be a good place for snipers to pick up their quad feeds at the beginning of the game if they get lucky. And don't make the mistake I did here and almost kill myself when jumping over that. You should definitely jump as opposed to just running. But that side, or this side rather, of the map seems to have the highest amount of traffic. Loads of people seem to come down here. This is what I found at least today. I got loads of nice little streaks down this little section. But like I said, when more people get the maps and they've been out for a little bit longer, the traffic may converge to a different area. But anyway, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed the video. If you have, please do be sure to leave a like rating. Very much appreciated. And don't fail like me and jump off that ladder to your